T-minus 13, 12, 11, 10, 9,
PLS is go
8,
for
go for main engine start, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0 and liftoff of Space Shuttle Atlantis, reaching the crest of its historic achievements in space.
And Houston, Atlantis is in a roll.
Roger, roll.
Houston is now controlling. The roll maneuver is complete. Atlantis is in a heads-down position on course for a 51.6 degree, 136 by 36 statute mile orbit.
Throttle down, turn 72.
Copy, in the bucket.
And the three main engines on Atlantis have now been throttled down to 72% of rated thrust. As the orbiter prepares to pass through the area of maximum dynamic pressure on the vehicle in the lower atmosphere. The engine's now beginning to throttle back up.
Atlantis, you are go at throttle up.
Copy, go at throttle up.
On PDL.
Copy, on PDL. Booster, how do the engines look?
Flight booster, all three look really good.
All three engines looking really good. Back at full throttle now at liftoff. The fully fueled shuttle, boosters, and external tank weighed 4.5 million pounds. It now has burned half of that liftoff weight in propellant. 1 minute, 30 seconds into the flight. All three auxiliary power units that provide hydraulic power to the orbiter's systems in good shape, as are the fuel cells, providing electricity to all of the systems on board. Atlantis is already 19 miles in altitude, downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 20 miles traveling, 2,500 miles per hour. Coming up on staging, the point at which the twin solid rocket boosters burn out and separate from the orbiter. Booster separation confirmed. The onboard guidance system has done its job of settling out any of the dispersions that have been introduced at the booster separation. Atlantis's performance thus far is exactly as planned. As Atlantis heads into orbit,